Good morning, class. How are you? I hope all you are well and fine, or your days are going on very well. Today, our discussion topic will be present perfect sentence building. Actually, last video lecture, you have learned what is present perfect and for what purpose we use present perfect and how we can recognize present perfect. Okay, that already we have discussed, and several points I have given you. According to that point, you might have understood very clearly. So today we are going to discuss about sentence building. Okay, sentence building of present perfect. Sentence building. Okay. So, before knowing of sentence building, that we have to clear about helping verbs. Okay, that we have to clear about helping verbs. So, you can see here, there are two helping verbs. One is has, and another is have. Okay. Another is have, and one is has. So here, for he, okay, she, it, and for singular noun or singular subject. Now you can see here have. It is for I, we, you, they, and plural subject. And plural subject or plural noun. Okay? So we have to use be, have to use verb of third form, verb of third form. We have to use here, point to remember, as for has, we use he, she, it, and singular name. As for have, I, we, you, they, and plural noun or plural subject. And it's very important, we have to use verb of third form. In other way, we say that past participle. Okay, past participle. Okay, so let us begin to start the sentence building. Okay, you know that in every tense, in every tense there are three. Suppose this is perfect, so we have four division. Okay, we have four division. Positive, negative, interrogative, interrogative, and interrogative, negative, interrogative, negative. So these are the four branches So according to that way, we have to build our sentences. So first of all, we will make your positive. Okay? To make the sentence, we need to have structure. Okay? We need to have structure. As per the structure, we see subject plus helping verb has or have. Okay, helping verb has or have. Then verb third and then object. Object complement etc. Okay, double object whatever may be there. Subject, helping verb and verb 3 and object. So this is for present perfect positive sentence. Okay, present perfect positive sentence. For example, I have written a letter. Okay, I have written a letter. Now you see the difference is here, verb third. This is verb third. And this part is object. And this part is helping verb. And this part is subject. Okay, subject, helping verb, verb third form, object, and also there may be complement or some other. Okay, according to the requirement, we can add there. Okay, now we will make some other sentences like this. You have seen Jaipur. You have seen Jaipur. Okay. They have taken. They have taken their. They have taken their dinner. Okay. Then we see some other. He has read that book. Okay, remember, we have to, there is no third form. It is true, there is third form, but the third form is written just like first form of verb. Okay, there is no any read, write, and read. Even the spelling is same, but in second form we can use the write and third form read. She has danced in the party. Okay, she has danced in the party. They have read the story. They have read this story. Okay, they have read this story. And also we can see that I have seen a horse. I have seen a horse. I have seen a horse. Okay. These are the examples of these are the example of simple present, a positive present indefinite. The teacher has taught English. The teacher has taught English. Either you can say that the teacher has taught us, the teacher has taught us, the teacher has taught us English. Remember here there is double object. Subject and helping verb, main verb and double object. There is double object, somewhere direct object and somewhere indirect object. Somewhere direct object and indirect object. But especially when I will teach you active passive voice, then I will say and what is direct object and what is indirect object. But now you have to remember only one thing, that there are two objects. One is for singular and one is for a direct object and another is for indirect object. Somehow, how it became direct object and how it became indirect object, that we will discuss when we will discuss about active passive voice. Now we have finished. We have finished this one. And now we are going to discuss about negative. Negative. The same way, subject, helping verb, then not, verb third, then object. The same sentence what we have written, and we can, we can just replace it, and in the third place we put not, then that would be convert into what kind of sentence? Negative of present perfect. For example, I have not written a letter to Shyam. I have not taken breakfast yet. Breakfast yet. Now you may see that there is also little bit different है ना, सब्जेक्ट हेल्पिंग वर्ब, नॉट मेन वर्ब, ऑब्जेक्ट एट द सेम टाइम एडवर्ब, एट द सेम टाइम एडवर्ब, येट मीन्स देर इज अ टाइम. ओके, नाउ आई वुड राइट यू थ्री और टू थ्री मोर सेंटेंसेस, देन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट मोर क्लियरली. दे हैव नॉट, दे हैव नॉट रीड दिस स्टोरी बुक, दिस स्टोरी बुक. वी हैव, वी हैव नॉट पेड मनी. ओके, वी हैव नॉट पेड मनी. सो दिस आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट नेगेटिव, बट नेक्स्ट वी विल सी दैट इंट्रोगेटिव. ओके, इंटरोगेटिव एंड वी विल सी दैट इंट्रोगेटिव नेगेटिव. Interrogative and interrogative. So what we do? First of all, helping verb, then subject, and then main verb, then object, okay, etc. Object and etc. means you know that. So let us write some other sentences. Have you ever visited to London? Finally, you have to put here question mark. Okay, finally you have to put your question mark, otherwise there will be little bit there will be problem. Okay, otherwise there will be problem. That cannot be recognized as present indefinite, sorry, present perfect. Okay, has she replied, has she written any letter to you? Okay, this is okay. So we can have some other examples that here the same sentences are here. What has she cooked? What has she cooked? What have you eaten? Sorry, This I will just repeat it. Okay, later. This is for WH word. Now you have to remember that when you make interrogative plus negative, just you have to do one thing. You can take this place and put here not. Okay. When you put here not, automatically that will be converted into interrogative negative. Has she not written any letter to you? Okay. So in this way, we have to make interrogative negative also. So you can expand your sentences. Not only if you have seen here 3 or 4, not only that, but you have to expand that and you have to make more and more sentences according to your idea. Then there is another unstable thing, that WH word. Okay, WH word. Okay, WH word, that already I mentioned when I taught you present indefinite or present continuous, what is WH word and how we can manage it. Number one, when WH word is there, so when we want to make interrogative, so first of all we have to put here WH word, then after helping verb, then after main verb, then after object, then after double object, whatever. Double object or whatever. That's depend on you. So, some more example. What have you done? Finally, question mark. What have you done? What have you eaten? What have you eaten? Why have you gone? Why have you gone? So these are the three examples. So you may think that here is third place. You can put here not. You can place here because these are one and two, and third place is here not. Why have you not gone? So according to this way, we have to make present perfect, positive, negative, interrogative, and the interrogative negative. Thank you. May God bless you. Yet if anybody hasn't subscribed this channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon. May God bless you.